Finally, Raspberry Pi OS officially supports Raspberry Pi 02W. This video is about how to set up the basic settings you need to do after purchasing a Raspberry Pi 02W. If your Raspberry Pi is already ready, you don't need this video. Please skip it. Also, this video is gonna be short. I will quickly show you only the essentials. Let's get started. The micro SD card I will be using has a size of 128GB. Raspberry Pi OS can only recognize a bootloader in FAT16 or FAT32, so we cannot use EXFAT for Raspberry. I will show you how to install Raspberry Pi manually from the scratch. If you don't like it this way, you can use an install via the Pi Manager. You can format the SD card to factory default through this formatter provided on sdcard.org. This removes all partitions on the SD card as well, so if your SD card already has a partition, you can delete everything easily. Here you are, SD card formatter is ready. My SD card already has an old Raspberry Pi OS, so it's partitioned. Select one of the two drivers, remove the volume label and start formatting. If you look at the result, you can see it's formatted as EXFAT. This is because Windows installed on MBR disk only allows formatting to EXFAT and NTFS if the SD card you are using has capacity larger than 32GB. The purpose of using this formatter was to remove the partitions on the SD card and do a factory reset. Now we will reformat it to FAT32 using another third-party formatter. There are many third-party programs that can format FAT32. It would be nice to use whatever you want. The program I use is from Ridgecrop Consultants Limited. With this, you can easily format a large size SD card to FAT32 on Windows. Alright, my 128GB SD card has been changed to FAT32 partition. All looks good. Now we need to download Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit. Since I'm gonna install it manually, let's download the OS image. You can see the devices that support 64-bit OS here. I will download Raspberry Pi OS with the desktop. If you don't need a GUI environment, please use OS right. I'm gonna create a desktop environment by connecting to an external monitor, so I'm downloading this. The disk image file is compressed. Since it's a zip file, unzip it. The OS image is ready, so we need to flash it to the SD card. I will use balenaEtcher. This enables OS image to be flashed on not only SD card but also USB. It supports Windows as well as Mac, which is very useful. I will download and install it. Very easy to use. First, select OS image file. Target selects SD card. Finally, press the flash button to start it. Flashing Raspberry Pi OS to SD card. It takes about 5 minutes. Let's move on quickly. After flashing, I remounted the SD card. You can see that boot and USB drive are mounted. Everything is fine. If you have an external monitor, keyboard and mouse, just connect the power. It will boot into Raspberry OS. For now, I will show you how to set up the headless Raspberry Pi. All we need to do is copy a couple of files to SD card to connect to the local network automatically. You must provide authentication for wireless access. SSID is the name of the network to connect to, and the pre-shared key is the password of this network. Key management is the encryption type of network. Usually WPA PSKey is in use, but check your network. You can download this file from my GitHub and modify it to your network. Copy this config file to the boot driver on your SD card. Even if the Raspberry Pi is connected to the local network, there is nothing we can do if it can be accessed from the other device. So we will enable SSH so that we can connect it through a terminal. To turn on this, create a SSH file with no context and just put it on the boot drive. Everything is ready for the Raspberry Pi. Now it's time to put the SD card into the Raspberry Pi and power it on. Insert the SD card worked so far into your Raspberry Pi, then connect the power cable. The onboard LED is blinking continuously. Blinking means something is being processed internally. I guess the first blink takes about 3 minutes. So it's recommended to wait patiently for the LED to stop blinking. When the flashing is over, it's now ready to use. You don't have to worry about the next booting as it won't take this long. Our Raspberry Pi is probably connected to the local network. As a way to check this, you can check the local IP address assigned to the Raspberry Pi by using the ping command in the terminal. If you cannot ping, your Raspberry Pi is not properly connected to the local network. Pre-check your SSID and password. An easier method is to access your wireless router directory and check the connected devices. With this, you can easily get the IP address assigned to your Raspberry Pi on your local network. We checked the Raspberry Pi is properly connected to the local network. Now let's try to connect through the terminal. You can easily access it through the SSH command. SSH PI at the assigned IP address. The default password is Raspberry. Yes, we are finally here in Raspberry Pi. Working in the terminal only is not fun, so let's make it work in the desktop environment via VNC. To enable VNC access, you need to enable it through the Raspberry Pi software configuration tool. Select interface options, VNC, enabling yes. From now on, you can access the GUI environment through VNC viewer. Let's install and run VNC viewer right away. You can easily download it by visiting realvnc.com. It just downloads and installs, so let me move fast. Here you are. After selecting file from the menu, select new connection. The VNC server is a Raspberry Pi, so enter the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. The name is a nickname for this connection. It's not a big deal, so you can put any name you want. Initiate a connection. Enter the username and password to connect to the server. Same as the SSH connection. The default name is Pi and the default password is Raspberry. The connection was established in the GUI environment. The welcome screen appears. Select country, language, and time zone. And the system is vulnerable because it's currently using the default user and default password. Be sure to change the password or register a new user to use the Raspberry Pi securely. The current VNC resolution is 640x480 VGA mode. This is too small. Seems like we have to change this. Open the terminal and run the Raspberry Pi configuration tool again. Select display options. VNC resolution. Choose the resolution you want here. I chose 1920x1080. Click finish and it will ask if you want to reboot. Yes, reboot it. After waiting for a while, the Raspberry Pi will reboot and the VNC viewer will try to reconnect it. It has connected again and we can see a very wide screen. Yes, it's a full HD resolution. Now all we need to do is change the password on the system or add a new user to make the system secure. Also, it's recommended to always update the system to prepare for new exploits. In today's video, it covered how to install Raspberry Pi OS with a 128GB SD card and set up basic settings before starting your project. I hope this was helpful for you. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.